Okay, we've talked about present value as far as the bonds. Let's now look at this and apply it. Now, if you come back over here, we said, how do you figure out the proceeds on the bond? We said face, par, $1 million face times the present value of a lump sum, 10%, boom. Plus 80,000 present value of an ordinary annuity, 5 years, 10%, boom. So the question is, okay, what does this mean? Where do these factors come from? Those are called present value. If you look in your notes, you'll see present value of an amount. That's present value of a lump sum. That's the amount you need to invest today at a certain interest rate for so many years to get back a dollar in the future. So that's called the present value of a lump sum. And that's going to be the present value as we go through the $1 million present value in 5 years, 10%. We'll look at that. Present value of an ordinary annuity. What is an ordinary annuity? That is an annuity. Where is it? Your rear is at the end of the year. That's when you're getting it at the end of the year. That is present value ordinary annuity. I just thought of a joke, but I won't say it. Present value of an annuity due now. Due now is up front. That's in advance. My example was like a lease, right? If you pay rent, you got to pay to the beginning of the month, not the end of the month. We have future values. This is how much the amount will grow into in the future or accumulate into. So if you look in your notes, future value of a dollar. So if I put a dollar in the bank at 10%, in 1 year, it'll be $1.10. In 2 years, it'll earn interest. On interest, compounding interest, that'll be $1.21. Okay, if you look at the 10%, 2 years, 1.210. So that would be future value. We don't use that as much. We use present value because we want to say how much is that money in the future worth today. Present value of a dollar. Now, how much do I have to put in the bank and it'll grow? In other words, a dollar in a year is worth what? So the present value of a dollar is worth how much? So if I get a dollar in a year, what do I have to put in the bank today at 10% for it to grow to a dollar? If I put in 0.909, if I put in 90.9 cents at 10%, it'll grow to a dollar. If it's 2 years, if I put money in at 0.826, then in 2 years, it'll grow to a dollar. And then in 3 years, and in 4 years, and in 5 years. So when we're talking about present valuing, what we're looking at is the present value of a lump sum is how much today. Basically, if you put, let's look at 10% 5 years, 0.621. So if I come back over here and I say $1 million and the present value of a lump sum in 5 years at 10%. Well, let's see what that is. The factor for the present value of a lump sum 5 years, 10% is what? Is 0.621, I think it was. 0.621, yes. So 0.621 times $1 million equals $621,000. So if I put $621,000 in the bank today, at 10%, it'll grow in 5 years to what? To $1 million. That means that if the person I'm loaning money to says, hey Raj, I'm gonna pay you back $1 million in 5 years, how much is that really worth today? It's worth at 10%. If I wanna earn 10, $621,000. Because if you put $621,000 in the bank today, at 10%, it'll grow to what? $1 million. Okay, then we have future value of an ordinary annuity. Again, not frequently used for our purpose here. Present value of an ordinary annuity, that's what we're looking at. Now, what is the ordinary annuity? Ordinary arrears at the end. When do you earn the interest? At the end of the year. So, what this says is, present value of an ordinary annuity, if you look down, how much would I have to put in the bank at 10% in order to get a dollar in a year? 0.909. Now, if I want a dollar in a year, and a dollar in 2 years, and a dollar in 3 years, and a dollar, so that's the present value of an ordinary annuity. So if I want a dollar at the end of the year, and another dollar at the end of 2 years, what is that worth today? 1.736, $1.73.6. How much dollar, a dollar, a dollar? $3. So you're gonna say, I'm gonna give you $3. It's really not worth $3, it's worth 2.487. Why is it worth 2.487? Because a dollar a year from today is not worth a dollar, it's worth 90 cents. And then a dollar 2 years from today is worth 82 cents. And a dollar 3 years from today is worth 75 cents. And a dollar 4 years from today is 6.68 cents. And a dollar 5 years is 62 cents. Because remember, what's a lump sum? The lump sum is 62.1. So if I said, if I put 62 cents in the bank 5 years from now, it'll grow to a dollar. Now, another way to look at this is when you look at the annuity, let's look back at the present value of a dollar. What is the present value of a dollar? Let's see. Present value, and this is 10% present value of a lump sum. So present value of a dollar. So in 1 year, 0.909. 2 years, 826. And we're only rounding, it's really 8265 or 9091, but they cut it off here. 0.751, 4 years, 0.683, 5 years, 0.621. If you add these up, this is how much I need to put. If I put 90 cents in a year, it grows to a dollar. 82 in 2 years, 3 years, 4 years, 5 years. When you add those up, that equals 3.791. Now, what is 3.791? Look at the present value of an ordinary annuity of a dollar, 10%, 5 years. That is really the present value of a dollar in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If you add them all up, that is the present value of an annuity, ordinary annuity, that's 3.791. So if you take that 3.791, that would be the present value what? The interest payments. Now remember, I'm getting 80,000 times the present value of an ordinary annuity for 5 years at 10%. Well, the factor for that is what? It's going to be $80,000 times this 3.791, 3.791. And of course, we all know that equals 303,280. So when you add this plus this, you end up with 924,280. That's how much we should charge in order for you to earn 10% when the bond is paying 8%. That is how much we should charge. Now, in my example, I just said 900,000, remember, for the discount example, because I didn't want to go through all that. But the real number would be 924,280. That is a formula. So this is present value of a lump sum, present value of an ordinary annuity.